So today we will see Playfair cipher. Playfair cipher is a substitution technique. So this was invented by Charles Wheatstone in 1854. So this Playfair cipher is a bit more secure. So why? Because it's more secure. The encryption method used in this Playfair is somewhat different. So the Playfair cipher uses a key matrix. That key matrix is a 5x5 matrix, which is a 25 character matrix. So in alphabets we totally have 26. So all the 25 alphabets will be placed in the key matrix. I and J will be placed in a single position. So if you see this example here, after I we don't have J because I and J is placed in a single cell. So here the keyword used is monarchy, that is MONARCHY, monarchy. So you have to take this keyword and you have to put it in a Playfair matrix. You start with MONARCHY, then start filling the remaining part of your matrix with the alphabets which is not present in your keyword. For example, A is already present in your keyword, so you start with B and check whether the next alphabet C is available in keyword. Yes, C is already available in your keyword, so omit and start with the next character D. So check whether D is available in your keyword. No. So you put D in the next cell. So like that, try to complete the entire 5x5 matrix and place your I and J in a single cell. Then we have 4 different rules to be followed. The first rule is, let us take a plain text, example balloon. So first you have to split the plain text into a pair of characters, that is BALLOON. So when you try to split the characters, if a pair has a same alphabet, then you have to put a filler letter X, that is, see this example. So BALLL cannot be in a single pair, so you have placed a filler letter X and then start filling the next 2 pairs, that is LO and ON. Suppose if the last pair doesn't have an end character, you just again fill with your filler character X. This is what your rule 1 says. Next is rule 2. So in this rule 2, what happen is, now let us take an example. AR is your plain text. So if the 2 characters that fall in a same row, then what we have to do, just see this matrix. If 2 characters, that is if 2 plain text characters AR falls under a same row, you have to take the next character of the previous one. For example, AR is your character. So for A, what is the next character? R. And for R, what is the next character? We don't have any character. So you have to certainly follow the last, that is M. So here AR can be written as RM. See here, AR is written as RM. That is, if both letters fall in a same row, replace each with the next letter to the right, that is next letter. So now we will see what is the rule 3. If both letters fall in a same column, so if both letters falls in a same column, so let us take the plain text characters M and U. So in this M and U, what happen is, so for M, what is the below character? C. And for U, what is the next character, we don't have any character. So we have to circularly follow the top, that is CM. So the example, see this example here, MU is encrypted as CM. So the last foremost important rule is, if the characters fall in a row and a column. So just see the example here, we will see the example for HS. So here H and S is placed in a different row and different column. So in this situation, first what you have to do is, so first take the H row and go to the intersection of the S. What is the character you have? B. And for S, what is the character you have? The same column for H, it's P. So your ciphertext will be B and P. Just see this, HS is encrypted as B, P. Now we will see for an example of EA, what actually happens for EA. So E is placed here and A is placed here. So we have to traverse in the same row of E until the intersection point of A, that is I. And for A, you have to traverse to the intersection point of E, that is M. So we have to take the ciphertext as I and M. See here, we can, EA is converted as IM or JM because I and J falls in a single cell. Now we will see what is polyalphabetic cipher. Another approach to improve security is to use multi-cipher alphabets, that is, instead of going with a single cipher alphabets, here we are going for multiple ciphers. So we will see with an example what does this multiple ciphers is. Here the keyword what we used is deceptive, and the plain text what we use is we are discovered, save yourself. This is your plain text. So what happen is, we have to take this keyword and we have to put it in your plain text. So you just see here DECEPTIVE. Once your keyword is completed, again start your keyword and just complete until end of your plain text. Then you just do the Caesar cipher process. So what is the value for D? 3, and take the appropriate value for W, which will be your Z. Like this, try to complete the entire cipher text. The main important thing here is, for each two characters you will not get the same value. Just see here, for E here you have H, and for E here you have M. So even if the crypt analyst try to decrypt your ciphertext, he will not get your actual message. That is why the polyalphabetic cipher is more secure. Next comes the transposition ciphers. So transposition cipher means we are rearranging the letter order. Just see here, hiding the message by rearranging the letter order. In substitution, we are going to replace a character with a letter or a number. In transposition, we are going to rearrange the letter order. Just see here, this is a rail fence cipher. In this rail fence cipher, we try to take the plain text message and we are forming in the form of a rail fence. So the plain text here is, meet me after the toga party. So how we are writing? M-E-E-T, M-E-A-F-T-E-R, T-H-E-T-O-G-A-P-A-R-T-Y. So like this, in the form of a rail fence, you are going to make your ciphertext. Just see here, and how to take the ciphertext? First, take all the characters in the first row, write it, then continue the characters in the second row to form your ciphertext. This is your ciphertext. That is, meet me after the toga party is converted as a ciphertext like this. And also we have another example. Here we will be giving a key. For example, this is your key, that is 4312567. So now the plain text what we have given is attack postponed until 2 a.m. So first you will start to fill all your characters in this matrix until, just see here, attack postponed until 2 a.m. If the remaining part of your matrix is empty, try to fill it from last, Z, Y and X. Afterwards, you take the characters in the first column and write it. Take the second column, take the third column, take the fourth column, fifth, sixth and seventh. Now your entire ciphertext is received. So this is a important technique which is called as Ralph Fiennes technique or Ralph Fiennes cipher. Thank you.